George Kenner here. Guess what I just did? I purchased a Stepcraft M1000 CNC machine with the largest working table and almost all the accessories. Now, I want to make this all relevant for the date that I pulled the trigger on the purchase, and that would be June 9th, 2021. A year from now, I may have made another decision, but this is the decision that I made on that date, so it's all time relative. I wanted to share that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to give you all the reasons that I purchased the machine, and then as time develops, the machine arrives and I do my first projects, I'm going to continue to share. So if you're interested in the Stepcraft product, and by the way, this is not sponsored. I paid for my machine. If you're interested, please subscribe, hit the like button, and we'll walk through this. Now, what happened was I saw a video, and I'm going to put a link to it down in the comments, and it was for a Dragon cutting board that was made with a CNC machine. It had 800,000 views when I saw it. It's the most beautiful cutting board I think I've ever seen. I thought to myself, what's that guy have that I don't have? The CNC machine. So what I did was I started to research. All of my friends make fun of me because I always grab a great big working tablet and I write all my ideas down and any of the research that I did. And I started to think, you know, I really like that. You know, I have some 3D photographic experience. I had one of the first Matterport cameras that was produced and out in the market. And I thought, you know what? I think I could do this. I understand it in XYZ axes, and I also have used, you know, many of the computer programs that utilize that, like Adobe Premiere Pro and After Effects. So why wouldn't I give this a try? So I decided to. Why, if I were to go to the biggest reason that I purchased, it was the support and the approach that the company took. I sent off an inquiry. I had a couple of small questions that I wanted to get answers to. Within an hour, I had a response. Next thing you know, one of the head guys from Stepcraft US is in contact with me saying, is there anything that would make you favor Stepcraft over another product? He was really trying to research. There was no hard sell. In fact, there is a book that is featured at their website that says how to start a CNC business. Now, let me make this clear. I'm not trying to start a CNC business. I looked at the cost of the machine. I want to remodel my kitchen. I liked the projects that could be done with it. And I decided, you know, I'm gonna do this. Now, I do have a girlfriend and she was, this could be a really good business. And that's something that she may pursue. One of the things that really impressed me with the Stepcraft product, one of the beneficial factors that drove me to the purchase, was they've taken the gantry system, gantry and table system, and not limited it to just a router. You can also put a laser on it, a 3D printer system on the gantry. They're thinking far ahead of most other companies. Also, in this size and cost of unit, it was one of the least expensive that I could find that had an automatic tool changer. So if you set up to do one job and you want to repeat it, so I wanted to make both my brother and sister a cutting board, I wouldn't have to go through and retool each and every time. That was an option that I couldn't find anywhere else. It's only something that I found on CNC machines that were much, much more expensive. It was like $100,000 more expensive. Of course, you're gonna get what you pay for, but I am very impressed with the quality of this machine. Even the driven bars that run the machine are of the highest quality and were comparable to those that I found on other machines that were even more expensive. So I factored in all the multiple uses, the vacuum bed that would hold it down, which would save me more time. I took all of these into consideration and I thought, you know, the reverse is really the way for me to go. As you can tell, I'm not a CNC expert yet. That creates a certain feeling in your stomach when you go to purchase something. Am I getting in over my head? Well, what I'm going to do is down in the comments, I'm going to direct you to an interview that was done by the director of Stepcraft US and a shop owner that is back in Connecticut that manufactures, I believe, both furniture and wants to go into cabinetry. Now, this man does this for a living, and I'm going to say that he was probably computer adverse. When you listen to these two gentlemen, you're going to find out, or at least it was my impression, that they were being very honest. One of the areas that I found to be something hard to master was the bit usage, the speed, which one you use, and why. The gentleman from the cabinetry shop that had just bought the machine with absolutely no experience clearly stated that Stepcraft helped him with that, as did the provider of the bits. I'm going to put a link to that down in the video. It is one of the things that drove me to purchase, so if you're considering a Stepcraft, you may want to watch that also. You may even learn something. Back to the plan. There's a couple of big things that I have to do, and some of them were driven by measurements. The machine that I'm buying is a little bit wider than the workbench toolbox that I have behind me, but I'm going to modify that to become the table for the CNC machine. One of the problems is it's about a half inch off of center. They slope garage floors when they build homes so that if there's any water on your car, it would drain out of the garage. I've got to fix that half inch. Air conditioning, got to have that. Too hot out here in the summer to really spend any time. Third thing, dust management. These things kick up sawdust. Now, of course, they do the other metals. They'll do aluminum and brass. They'll do carbon fiber. You can use it for a vinyl cutter. All of that I've already covered. But I don't want to deal with a lot of sawdust. So I'm going to have to come up with a really good dust mitigation system. Bosch makes one that looks like a shop vac. I'm going to give that some consideration. But if there's anybody out there, I'm brand new to this. If you've got a really good idea for me, please put it down in the comments. I understand that the CNC hobby community is really very nice group of folks and that, you know, they really try and help each other. So if you subscribe or you leave a comment, I promise that I'll continue to follow up and show you the progress that I'm making. Nice thing is it's a two-car garage. I can get this in here and still get both of my cars in the garage. So I'm not really sacrificing that much. It's going to take a little bit of shifting things around. I may have to give up with a toy, a move toolbox, something like that. But it'll all fit in here, and I think it's going to be all very manageable. I hope to see you in the very near future. If you're thinking about starting a CNC business, the only thing I tell you to do is, my girlfriend got addicted to watching Titan Gilroy from Titans of CNC. Talk about a positive story for the world. This guy is incredible. I'm going to put a link to his life story. He's a CNC entrepreneur, and if I were president of the United States, I'd put him in charge of bringing manufacturing back to the United States. I wish you all the best. I hope to see you in a couple days. 3 weeks, it sounds like, till the machine. We'll let you know as soon as it arrives. Thank you.